The Jets.
I feel like it's gross.
We've seen grosser on this show.
Yeah.
Is it possible that Mike White's just better than Zach Wilson?
Oh, no.
White Mike!
White Everybody Mike. Knows the White Mike, though. It's a real thing. I don't know if it's the same thing for you guys, but I don't know a black person who doesn't know a White Mike. I know a couple, and you call them White Mike.
I'm happy to be your guy's White Mike, by the way.
No, I was going to say, Gojo, it would be my honor if you would take, if I could take your hand and be, you know, your friend, so you could be my White Mike.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, man.
Yeah, thanks, Dominic. There it is. Yep. Thank you for saving me with a dab.
Nope,
all
nope.
right.
The whitest Mike thing that you can possibly do.
That's why I'm glad to have him in my life. So the real football answer to this feels like we actually can't say for sure one way or the other. And that's what's most sad for Zach Wilson. Like, I feel like what we've seen from White Mike in one game against a team that we had just all kind of agreed was maybe, I mean, at the very least, one of the best teams in the AFC in the Cincinnati Bengals had just blown out the Ravens last week. Like, for him to do this against that team, it's not, I mean, obviously it is by definition a fluke so far. It is the best only thing we've seen him do. But it feels like there is a conversation that shouldn't be laughed out of the room in terms of how good White Mike might be.
I mean, and also how bad Josh has been. Like, it's been, it's Zach. Hasn't been, oh, I'm thinking of Josh. Who am I thinking of? Josh Wilson?
You're just throwing out arbitrary white names.
Josh Wilson is a cornerback that I played with at Maryland. He played in the league for a little while.
Was he white?
No, he wasn't. I said he was a cornerback. Come on,
no, that's a good point.
Cornerback, not quarterback, a cornerback.
Oh.
I think Zach Wilson, yeah, it's an indictment on Zach Wilson's performance so far that we could even consider this, but it's hard to completely dismiss this out of hand because it's not like they were playing a slouch, and it's not like he was being propped up by a loaded roster. Like, no. Like you were out there with a team that none of us thought was going to be any good against a team that was the number one in the AFC as of 12 o'clock on Sunday.
Correct.
So, like, it's hard to dismiss all this. If you rewatch it, like, he's not doing incredible things, but that tends to be the case for good young quarterbacks is early in their careers, with the exception of guys like Patrick Mahomes and maybe we give it to Justin Herbert. Even the good young quarterbacks, Russell Wilson, Dak Prescott, Tom Brady, even when they were good early in their careers, they weren't blowing us away. Like, they weren't shocking us with their ability to read defenses and make tight window throws. They were just making good decisions consistently, and they're normally protected by a good roster. Mike White don't got that.
I will say, he got helped out by a defense that punched Cincinnati in the mouth yesterday. Like, to me, that was much more about Cincinnati being new to this whole success thing, because they came out there and they got whooped up front for a little bit here. You look at this game, Mike White, Seth Walder pointed this out. Mike White completed 82% of his passes yesterday. The average air yards on those throws, 3.7 yards.
Yeah.
And this is also a Jets team that turned the ball over three times in the first half. Like, this was the same old Jets performance here. The team on the other side just wasn't able to capitalize. You got down into the red zone once. You got no points out of it. I think you had 10 points off those first three turnovers overall here. Like, Mike White did really good, and I'm not going to limit what White Mike could potentially do in the future here or step on his moment. I heard him talking after the game. I heard the crowd. They were chanting my name, and I was just hoping they would calm down so that we could go out here and execute the plays. Like, he was living in the moment, and I don't want to step on that for him, but, like, the quarterback play wasn't that far
above what we
got from Zach.
It didn't come across on the TV copy for me or whatever, but the idea that they were chanting White Mike, it makes me so happy, because even if they're chanting – Mike White, eventually,
that's right.
It turns into White Mike. Like, that is tremendous. How did I not experience this? Is this on the internet somewhere?
No, Dominique, if it's not on the internet, we snip off the first, like, half second and the last half second, and absolutely we get exactly what you were saying.
Mike,
great point.
He didn't even play all the snaps. Like, I turned on the game when I'm flipping through channels trying to watch as many games as possible, and I noticed that there was someone playing quarterback who was decidedly not named Mike.
Well, listen, before we get too ahead of ourselves with the whole, like, White Mike supremacy thing, I do feel like it's worth pointing this out. The Cincinnati Bengals really did not get – Gojo, you just said it. The Bengals, man, like, they went from laughingstock to overdog and really didn't get to enjoy very much of that whole trajectory, which normally you would get to do. But instead, no, they get punched in the face by a Jets team that is underdogging them, which means that the Bengals got none of the benefit. None of it. None of the benefit of the doubt from being like this Cinderella story. They're already a favorite that choked. Congratulations, Cincinnati Bengals. I apologize.
His name was Josh.
By the way, we...
Johnson.
Yeah, I was just going to say, Josh Johnson was the one.
I had to look it up. Sad. But I
let
know
them
he
on
wasn't
a,
right.
Let them on a drive that ended in a field goal.
Maybe that's why I said Josh Wilson earlier. I was thinking of Josh Johnson. Yeah, it would have been a touchdown, but it bounced off his receiver's chest in the end zone. White Mike may not have ever come back in the game if he would have got a catch there. Nah, he probably wouldn't have. They would have brought him back.
Damn, everyone giving White Mike credit for Josh Johnson's drive here. Ain't that America?
Oh, man. Goddamn America. Oh, did I get us all fired?
No!
Oh, man. That's all freeze.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.